Rafael Nadal was born in Mallorca, the Spanish island that he still calls home. He returns here every chance he gets.
Mallorca, Manacor is my life. You know? It's where I have all the people that I really love. The family, all the friends, everybody. The island is just amazing, and I love the sea. I love the calm, and here I can find all these kind of things. The only thing that you cannot do it here is a ski on the snow, but the rest of the things, you have it.
Nadal is now focusing on a strong start to 2017 after suffering a mid-season wrist injury that forced him out of Wimbledon and the French Open.
It has been a tough season because I get injured in the worst moment possible, no? So that's the real thing. So just accepted that, and you get injured in the middle of the season, then the comebacks are tough. Just trying to recover the level, trying to feel myself 100% ready again, and that's my work of every day now.
Nadal returned to action in time to compete at the Rio Olympics and carry the flag for Spain. He finished with another gold medal, this time in the doubles competition, alongside close friend Marc López.
I play at a great event, no? And achieve the gold medal is a unique moment, but at the same time, even more special doing with one of my best friends.
The 14-time Grand Slam champion reached another milestone when he opened his own sports centre and academy in his hometown of Manacor. Tennis legends John McEnroe and Mats Wilander paid Nadal a visit in Manacor for a private tour of the new tennis academy.
I can't imagine growing up in Manacor and literally playing tennis 2 minutes away from here his whole life, and then suddenly you build your own academy in your hometown. I mean, that's incredible.
I don't know if it's going to be the last academy, but for me the most important thing is to build the first one here. It's where I live, where I'm going to live, and it's the only chance to be really involved. I am here every day, you know, so I can see, I can be close to the kids, I can be close to the coaches.
You know, I have an academy in New York, but this has got hotels, schools, basketball courts, soccer fields, everything. This is great for Mallorca, and I think, Rafa's got to be very proud of this.
It's an important moment of my career, you know. A lot of years dreaming of having something like this, and finally that dream come through.
The Rafa Nadal Sports Center includes several sports grounds, fitness and health services, and a state-of-the-art spa. Part of the facility is a sports museum where Nadal keeps all of his Grand Slam trophies. The complex took nearly 2 years to build. Rafa teamed up with telecom company Movistar to fund the project.
It's good to have kids here now studying, trying to become the next professional tennis players, and we created everything that a kid needs to be in all aspects in the best hands possible. We have a medical center inside, so we have more than what the kid really needs.
On opening day, thousands were treated to an exhibition match that was anything but ordinary. Four former number ones shared one court. Mats Wilander, John McEnroe, and the two local heroes, Carlos Moya and Rafa himself.
Well, it's something so special, no? And especially here in my hometown in Manacor, I think the people enjoy it, so just very happy for that.
Shortly after the Asia swing, Nadal decided to bring his 2016 to a close. He wants to be fully fit before the new year. Despite the setback, one of the game's greats is confident. We'll be hearing a lot more from Manacor's most famous resident.
Roger Federer's 17 majors is still within reach. He's only 30 years old. I mean, you know, I think that people are worried about his health. Yeah, he's going to get injured because he's a crazy man. You know, he takes himself into the ditch, so to speak. You know, he drives himself into the ground and then it comes back.